Hello, hi and namaste. Today I am going to talk with you about the remittance, how it is impacting to the Nepalese economy. First we'll see the definition. A remittance is a fund of expatriate sent to his or her country of origin by a wire, mail or online transfer. These peer-to-peer transfer of funds across the border are economically significant for the many of the countries that receive them. Remittance has played an increasingly large role in the economics of small and developing countries. Since the late 1990s, remittance have exceeded the development aid and in the some cases make up significant portion of the economic country's gross domestic product. For example, remittance from overseas workers back to Nepal amounted to 30% of the nation's GDP in 2016. Let's consider some facts regarding the Nepalese economy and its GDP and impact on the in the form of remittance. Contribution of remittance in the GDP was 1.7% in 1993, which rose to 30% in 2017. Third position on the world in terms of remittance is the percentage of GDP by talking about the Nepal. And Nepal stay on the 23rd position in terms of inflow in the dollars, that is in terms of money. According to World Bank in 2016. In 2016, remittance contributes the 29.6% gross domestic saving, which is nearly one third of GDP. One third of GDP. 79% of remittance in Nepal is spent on the consumption of goods. And there are 60 various nations where Nepali people fly for the job, and 29 million in foreign employment last 10 years. Net domestic saving is now 15%. It is only possible due to the. Let's see the some push factor. Why people go for the foreign job? First is low income of the nation. Second, poverty line. Third, in Nepal we have the high unemployment because only per year 2% population rate is there for the formal sector, whereas nearly 5 lakh population come for the job market. Low wages, we have less than 15,000 basic minimum wages, and which is not sufficient to fulfill the family demand, and large political instability, and Nepali society is victim of demonstration effect. We need to do the competition for buying house, making house and coloring house and consumption of other goods. And some pull factors, why people really think that foreign job is necessary, because it provides the better salary and there is market for low skill labor. In international way, trust in Nepali employer increasing, and this is also another factor of globalization effect. Remittance flow. In 2017, high inflow of remittance is in India, China, Philippines, Mexico and Nigeria. In Nepal, contribution of remittance in last 5 years is average 27%. It shows the counter-cycling effects on income, saving, investment, consumption, income distribution and poverty reduction are the positive side of economy due to the remittance. Decreasing child death rate, mother death rate, malnutrition rate and increase the access of education and health, which is helping to improve the living standard of people. Some people starting business after coming back from the foreign country by utilizing their skill on the outside of. Why remittance decrease these days? recent years the trend of remittance in Nepal is decreasing, and there are some reasons: low motivation to sending in money in Nepal, and economic condition of Nepal is not that much good, and people like to ownership of assets. They like to buying house, starting business, the country where they travel for the work. Transformation mechanism in Nepal, nearly 60% of money come from the informal channel, and the people who have the high skill, they have the saving aim and investment aim for better future for their family, and salaries and benefit, higher the salary, higher the benefit, they less like to send the money in Nepal. Let's move in the when inflow rise, or in what condition inflow is rise in Nepal. Different in interest rate of the home country and foreign country. If Nepal have the higher interest rate by comparing to the foreign country, inflow may rise. Economic condition of family. If the economic condition of family is poor, there is the high flow of remittance. During festivals seasons, remittance will increase, and the lower the skill of manpower, he or she send the more money to the Nepal. Marital condition, the people who is married, he or she send more money to the Nepal. Depreciation of Nepalese currency. If depreciation happens, lower inflow, the foreign employment send the more money to the country. Why low trend is there? Due to the strong base, we have the strong base of the remittance, decrease in foreign employment number comparing to the past years, and low invoicing and informal transfer like hundi, and high cost of formal remittance, that hundi is more cheaper or informal channel is more cheaper than the formal channel. Political instability, carrying gold from abroad than cash because they have the transaction benefit. Due to the payment of the university fee, if any student is traveling to the outside, he or she may not be able to send the money for early 5 to 10 years. Low trend impact in economy. Negative impact on the balance of payment. Problem in the financial statement due to the low reserve of foreign currency. Reduction on saving of bank. Negative balance of trade due to the lower impact, lower remittance. Impact on family saving and investment. Lower tax of income of the government. Increased poverty and impact on imports. Because Nepalese economy is import base economy, and remittance fed the import. So if there is low remittance, we are not able to do the higher imports. Remittance management. How we can manage the remittance, or how we can maintain the flow of remittance. First, encouraging the migrate to choose the formal channel, lower the cost of remittance channel, supervision and control of illegal channel, use of remittance on the productive sector, demotivate to the low invoicing process, transparency in the transaction of remittance company. Future prospects. Provide the competitive interest rate to the remittance-based money. Invest in the long-term infrastructure and tourism-based industry. Transfer of the migrant structure from unskilled to semi-skilled and high-skilled, that they can earn the more money. Use the fact-based research to inform the policy design for the policy level.